I am proud to say something to you tonight, guys. I am no longer afraid of the relative I have always been afraid of. I feel like it's a real emotional breakthrough for me. I spent most of my life very afraid of my Aunt Cindy, because my Aunt Cindy is a scary lady. She's also here, so this is fun. She's also never heard this, so this is funner. My Aunt Cindy has spent most of my life enjoying three things and three things only, and those are smoking cigarettes, drinking gin, and talking shit. Yeah, you're not related to her, so it's fine. I'm a fat teenager most of my life. It's like being a little round target. So I'm just running from room to room, trying to assess the situation. And then I hit a certain age where all of a sudden I realized, oh shit, I have become a man, because those hobbies are not that different from some of my own. And it was on that day where I sat next to her and realized that she went from my scary aunt to one of my closest friends. Because I can say, hey, pour me a drink, let's shoot some shade. Yeah. I'm no longer a target, I don't care, let's tear these people apart. Now, that's a great time. It's made Christmas a lot of fun. It made last Christmas the most fun, though, because now my Aunt Cindy starts to get hammered and just tell me stories my mom made her promise to not tell. And this past Christmas, my aunt gave me a great gift, and that was just the bit I'm about to say. Let me limber up for this. Because I need to start this story with a precursor. And that is that my cousin Andrew, her son, is fine. That's gonna be really important information in a few minutes. And I don't need anybody in this room going like, "Oh, he's a high school science teacher. Everything's great. He's healthy. He, I think, owns a home. He's doing fine." And I need you guys to be okay with that because she smoked and drank through that whole pregnancy. See? Are you glad you know now? It's like, he's making an awful big deal. Oh, he was right. He was super right. You see, what happened is the doctors said if you smoke and drink, which you shouldn't do, your baby's gonna come out small. And what my aunt heard was if you smoke and drink, your baby's not gonna fuck your shit up as bad. And here's the problem, ladies and gentlemen. She was right. That tiny, healthy baby shot out and fucked up years of cancer research. Have you ever seen a doctor hide a healthy baby before? They're like, we can't let this little data point ruin our funding. Get him out of here. And here's the thing, guys. My aunt is nothing if not a fun lady. So it's not like she's just sitting at home going like, bah, what is a lady to do besides smoke and drink and be pregnant? No, she's a doer. And what she did was spend most of the early 80s drinking and smoking inside of biker bars in the San Fernando Valley. She says that it's because they played the best music. In case you're wondering, I'm pretty sure that just means a lot of Bob Seger. So for the rest of this story, just fill in whatever tracks off of The Greatest Hits Volume 1 or 2 that you want. Dealer's choice. Because imagine this, in this first part of the story, she is smoking, she is drinking, she is in a biker bar, she is pregnant, and she is dancing the night away standing on a table. She is full tilt dancing on a table, belly out, just living life. And some biker has decided all of a sudden that he has a moral center and walks over and takes her drink and her cigarette away. And my aunt, being my aunt, swung at him and said, "Who the fuck are you?" But a lot slurrier. And it looks all of a sudden like my Aunt Cindy is about to get in a fight with a biker. Until a second biker comes up and breaks up the fight and says, "Hey, don't fight this pregnant lady." And the other biker says, "Hey, you better watch your woman." And the biker says, "Oh, no, 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 no. That is not my girlfriend. I would never let my girlfriend smoke and drink while that pregnant. That is wildly irresponsible. I just don't want to see you deck a pregnant lady. It's gonna ruin my night. So don't." And she turned around and went, "Yeah, fuck you." And then after that, she had that healthy baby. But I wish that were the end of the story. Because here's what's great, is after that, she was like, well, now I'm a mom, I'm a mother. I can't just be out all night at biker bars all willy-nilly. I have to have a criteria. And that one point criteria is this. They have to have glass tables. Some of you understand why, I assume your parents. Those younger, a glass table, you can put your baby underneath and you can keep an eye on it without taking precious space for ashtrays or drinks. And as a side result, there's like a force field, so things aren't directly blowing onto your child. Now, she's in a bar with a glass table. It's 11 p.m. It's a Thursday night. We're in the San Fernando Valley. We're at a different biker bar. She is upgraded. And a different Bob Seger song comes on. Time has moved on. Let's assume a new single is out. And she's like, son of a bitch, I gotta dance. But I got this pesky baby. What's a girl to do? What's a mother to do? And what does she do? She says, hey, biker bartender, hold my baby, I gotta dance. And the biker says, hey, it's 11 p.m. at a biker bar on a Thursday. We did not know there was a baby in here. That baby's for sure not 21. And she's like, yeah, I put him under the table. I figured you guys would make a thing of it. And like, fair enough. She's like, so you're gonna hold my baby or not? He's like, well, clearly you love to dance. And who am I to stop a woman with dreams? So you know what we're gonna do? We're gonna put some teamwork together here. We're gonna fire up that grill. And we're going to turn ourselves back into a bar and grill. Because a non-21-year-old baby, if that has food, it can hang. He goes, hey, biker chef, make this baby a burger. And that biker chef's like, hey, we're probably making meth back here. This is the 80s in the valley. I think we might be closed for business as far as culinary things are concerned. And they're like, well, I can't shut the meth operation down. But I'm emotionally invested at this point. I need to see this story end with a happy ending. So they sent a guy across the street to a fast food restaurant to get my baby cousin a burger. And then they set that burger on my baby, or on my cousin. And it was warm and he fell asleep on it and my aunt got to dance. Now, I've been telling that bit for a long time now. And I sometimes like to try to find a moral in the story. And there's not always one, but I think I found one in this. And ladies and gentlemen, if that story tells you one thing, it's do not ever let anybody tell you what you can't do. Oh, man.